how to become a model. So here in this video, I'm gonna tell you my story, and I'm also gonna share some tips on how the process works. So when I was 16 years old back in Brazil, I had been dreaming about becoming a model for the past 3 years. I bought every magazine. I'd study poses. I would like put posters on the wall of the models, and I just was obsessed with the modeling industry. Then a big modeling agency came to my hometown for a contest, which is a big way that they do to find new models. They'll have a contest in different states, then they'll have a final in the big city to do the final girls. So I was selected in my hometown, I won, then I went to the finals, and I didn't win the final, someone else won. But at the final, there were many agents from different modeling agencies looking at girls, and most girls got a contract. So that's how I got into the modeling industry. But before that, I was doing fashion shows in my hometown. My cousin would put me into fashion shows so I could get experience, learn how to walk, learn how to pose, how to do my own makeup. And that was a great way to start having some experience and being comfortable in that situation before I went to the big city. So then I went to São Paulo. They called my mom. They talked to my parents, which is very important. If the agency is not involving your parents, you gotta be very aware. They always have to involve your parents, especially if you're under 18. So they called my parents, they made sure everything was okay, we signed a contract, and then they invited me to spend a month in São Paulo when I had vacation from school. So we did, we went. Me and my mom, we went to São Paulo, which was a huge city compared to the city I grew up, Uberlândia. And we arrived in this big city and we didn't know how to get around, and it was super scary, and we were very frazzled with all the cars and how fast everything was. Then we went to the model's apartment. Before we stopped at the agency to sign all the contracts, and they measured me right away. Got off a long trip and they put me in a bikini, and right away they first took digitals, which every agency will do. Either you're signing up for the first day, or you're trying to get in when you go for an interview, when they have those called open calls, which every agency does. If you're trying to become a model, always Google when they have open calls. And then you were gonna go to the agency, and this is what they would do. They take digitals of you in a bikini, front, sideways, back, have you pose a little profile so they can see your beauty raw. How do you look natural? Then after that, they're gonna measure you, your height, your waist, everything, hips, and they take all your measurements. That's for when you book a job, the client knows what size clothes they have to get for you. And also, they have to see if you fit in the size measurements that are required by modeling and the height. So that got done. Then we went to the modeling apartment. And it sounded very, very excited. But once I got there, I was like, is this the model apartment? I couldn't believe it. I imagined this glamorous mansion. It was just an apartment with a bunch of bunk beds, and all the girls stay in the same apartment. Girls from all over the country, everyone starting the business. And me and my mom was like, I'm not sleeping here, I'm getting a hotel. But the reason she did that is because she told me this, which was very smart that my mom did that. She said, I'm gonna go sleep in a hotel by myself, and you're gonna stay here tonight on your own. Tomorrow morning, when I go back to our city, you're gonna see if you were able to stay by yourself. You're gonna sleep here on your own. So my mom went back to the hotel, and I stayed in the model's apartment by myself. And I didn't know anyone, and all the girls were already there. They already had a relationship. They were joking, giggling in the room, and I was super shy at that age. So I was just sitting in the living room, staring at a wall. Just, what do I do? I didn't even know what to do. Everything was so much. And one of the girls was really nice. She invited me over. Hey, come in the room with us. And that was that. The next day, I woke up early and I did not sleep all night. I cried. I wrote my mom a letter saying how I was so sad and how it was hard to be away from home and I had to be alone. But I had to do it. I wrote her this big letter and I told her, Mom, it was tough, but I want to stay and I want to do this. And we hugged and cried, and she went back home. Then the agency sent me to my first photo shoot, because you need to have a portfolio when you start modeling, so the agency can send out to all the clients. But if you're starting, what you really need is to look fresh and great and go to the open call or go to the agency meeting, and they will take digitals from you and they can start just with that. But once they already had done that with me, then we went to do the photo shoot. Okay, so I've never done a professional photo shoot before, and I get there and everything's fast and music blasting and lights getting set up. And the hairdresser, which was a great hair and makeup guy, doing my hair, doing my makeup in a way that I had never got it done before. I mean, the guys that work in the fashion industry, the makeup artists, guys and girls, they just have this talent to make you look your best version of yourself. They're amazing. You get to work with the best makeup artists and hairdressers in the world. He did my hair amazingly and this beautiful makeup, which I didn't even recognize myself in the mirror. Then we go in front of the camera, and I was just like, oh my God, what do I do? What do I do with my hands? What do we do with my arms? What do I do? I was so, so green. And that's okay. The photographer knew that. I was very young, and he guided me and directed me, and we got some photos, but it was a very cool experience. So a little tip, before you start, always practice in front of the mirror. Watch, look at magazines, rip off pages, and rehearse and take photos of yourself with your phone. You can film yourself doing poses so you can kind of watch how you look like, discover your best angles, discover how you look, how you look your best self, you know, like front, sideways, and different angles from the camera and up and down. Anyway, I had no idea what I was doing, but I was directed by the photographer, got my first portfolio done, and then next day was go time. Next morning, we had to go to all the castings, and the agency either had us go on our own, which you gotta figure it out. You take a bus, you take a cab, you walk, you figure it out. You got a map, you got a list of clients you gotta go see, and you're on your own. And also, they did have a big van in Brazil where they drove all the models. When it was a big casting, they had to see a lot of girls, they took us. But most of the time, you had to do it on your own. And here you are, I'm in São Paulo. I have no idea where I am. My first modeling gig, I remember, it was like a beauty shot for Avon. I got lost. I was supposed to be at the job at 3 p.m. and I didn't arrive until 11 o'clock at night. By the time that I got to this job, there was the agency had called 100 times. The client was thinking about calling the police, and I arrived. I'm sorry, guys. I took the wrong bus, which took me to the wrong side of town, and then I had to take 3 other buses to come back, and I finally arrived. But which is cool looking back was that I didn't go home. I stayed, and I kept trying until I arrived to my photo shoot. So that kept happening, you know, I stayed in São Paulo for a couple of years. Eventually, I got a contract to go to Europe, and I spent 4 years in Europe, and I worked in London, Milan, Paris, Germany, Portugal, Switzerland, and many more. And then from there, finally, I got a contract to go to New York City, which was my dream. And once I got to New York City, I decided to stay. And I stayed there for 15 years, living in New York, traveling the world, modeling, and working with the most incredible people you can think of. So, if you want to become a model, do your research. Google every agency in your area. Make sure they're serious. You don't have to pay to join an agency. They may just advance you some stuff and then you pay them back with your first work. Don't pay. Sometimes when they ask you to pay for stuff, it's actually a course where they're trying to get money from you for you to learn stuff, like a course telling how to model. But a real agency will have you come for an interview. They'll have you come in a black tank top, tight jeans, bring a bikini, looking fresh. Modeling agencies do not like when you wear heavy makeup. They want to see your raw beauty. Then you're going to go in, mostly on open calls, and they're gonna see you. They're gonna ask you to walk, take a couple digitals, and be prepared for that and rehearse at home. Another way the agencies can find you are through a modeling contest. And they will have a contest and you can sign up and see if you make it to the finals, or at least if you get to meet some agents that you can work with eventually. or just for the experience. But don't give up, because I know models that it went to agencies and they were turned down. Then they went to another agency and they got signed up. Sometimes you're just not the right look for that agency at a time. Sometimes they already have the same look at the agency, so they don't need another one. For example, I don't need another brunette, we already have 10. It depends. And the contest as well. The contest is a great experience when they do those, for example, the one I was, the look of the year from Elite Models or for those, a bunch of agencies, they do contests. It's because you get to spend a few weeks with them and you kind of do drills on how to model. You participate in different situations that kind of get you a little bit more ready for the market. But do your research, send your photo out to a bunch of agencies. They love natural. And then once you go for the interview, be prepared. They're going to ask you a couple questions, but what they really want to see is your natural beauty and your personality. So don't be shy. Don't be scared to show a personality. Show them who you are, because that's the main core about modeling, is you bring yourself, your looks and your personality to every job. And that's going to sell the product and make you a great model. There's so many stories, so many tips that I have for you. So keep watching my videos and send me a comment below if there's anything you want to know about. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you.